Bible School. Many of you have driven in from out in the country or other towns, and we appreciate the efforts you have made in joining us this evening. Let's look to God in prayer. Father in heaven, thank you for this day, for your blessings, for bringing us together to worship you, to be fed from your word. Bless the members of the Choral Club and the director of the group, that they would be instruments of yours to bring honor to you. May our hearts and the reception of your word in our hearts also bring honor to you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The Choral Club, under the direction of Mrs. Marion Christofferson, is from our AFLC Bible School in Minneapolis. We welcome them. God bless you as you share with us tonight.
Thank you. hour today, and I just like to say what a privilege it's meant to me. Before I went there, I guess I didn't realize what a privilege it would be, and I've just come to realize that there aren't a whole lot of people that get to have that opportunity in their life to dedicate 2 years of their life to just studying the Word of God. And so there's a lot of focus on a personal relationship with God there. Daily devotions and prayer is really emphasized. And we have devotions to, dorm devotions, school devotions, board devotions. And then there's devotions before class every day too. And if you're wondering why anybody would want to go to Bible school, basically, to sum it up, it's about spiritual growth. And I'd just like to read 2 Peter 3:18, which says, "But grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ." And that is what it's all about. It's about growing closer to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And it's just a wonderful place to go if you want spiritual growth. When you live and go to school with other Christians about your age every day, it's just, for me, it's really eye-opening to see that there are other people my age that are Christians, and it's just great to have that fellowship. We are called to have that Christian fellowship, and the Word tells us that, and that's, you know, what going to church is all about, too, is to have that Christian fellowship. And I just like to tell you why I decided to go. A good friend of mine, Holly Rose, just reminded us too. I really didn't think much about going until she decided to go, and I don't think I told her, but she was a strong Christian influence for me in high school, and I just like to thank her for that. And I really believe God called me to go to Bible school. It was just very apparent to me. I was kind of in high school a lukewarm Christian, that I was doing okay, but I realized that God doesn't like lukewarm Christians, and it was time for a change, and Bible school has done that for me. And just like to share a little bit about specific things that have changed in my life. I took a lot of things for granted before coming to Bible school, and one is the Christian family I was raised in. I'm grateful to God for that now. I just didn't realize what a blessing that was before I came to Bible school, because there are many people my age that don't have that opportunity. And one major thing that I've come to learn is, I guess, the whole salvation and Jesus dying for the cross for me wasn't, I mean, I knew He did it for me, and I guess I just didn't see how personal it was, and that He died, you know, for me specifically, and just didn't think it was all that personal. And I've come to realize how much that is true. I'd like to read Philippians 2:8. "And being found in appearance as a man, He humbled Himself and became obedient to death, even death on a cross." And this is just a verse that I really like, and especially since Easter tomorrow. But this is a verse we need to know every day. And just the words "became obedient to death," that's something I didn't really think about before coming to Bible school. That I didn't really, I guess, realize that Jesus had a choice, that He could have, you know, told God, "No, I'm not going to die for everybody." But He obeyed God because He loves us so much. And that's just amazing to me that He died for us, you know, the very people that mocked Him and spit upon Him and despised Him. And that just shows us how great His love is for us. And so there's some specific things that I've come to know through Bible school. And I just, like I say, I encourage anybody to go there, even if you're 50 years old. It's never too late. And I just praise God for the opportunity that He's given me. Thank you.
Hallelujah. I think most of you probably know me. For those of you who don't know, my name is John Miller. I'm from Grand Forks. And I would just like to share with you a little bit of my testimony. I know that God has really given me just so many good blessings. I mean, everything. First of all, a great Christian family. They parents who taught me God's word, who brought me to church every Sunday, and not just any church, but a church where I could hear the word of God preached every week. And I just the word of God just works in people, and at times I don't always understand everything, but it can still work in us. And then, I'd like to say, when I was in seventh grade is when I went to my first year of Bible camp. And at the time, I really thought, yeah, you know, I was pretty good. I'm pretty righteous and everything. But during that week, I mean, for some reason, many of my attitudes and behaviors really were not righteous. I was kind of mean to some of the kids there, or some of the others, and just not really acting the way a Christian should. And some verses that, you know, perhaps they characterize my nature and the nature of all of us who be before we really know Jesus. Romans 3, verses 10 through 12. There was no one righteous, not even one. There is no one who understands, no one who seeks God. All have turned away. They have together become worthless. And another verse, Ephesians chapter 2, verses 1 and 2, it says, "As for you, you were dead in your transgressions and sins, in which you used to live, when you followed the ways of this world, and of the ruler of the kingdom of the air, the Spirit, who is now at work in those who are disobedient." And at this Bible camp, many people have maybe been there. Every evening we have a campfire where we sing and give testimonies and stuff. And so it's after that campfire we have our devotions. And many of the kids in my cabin, we were not very mature, and we were really not paying attention at all during the devotions. So our counselor changed the subject. He asked us, "If you were to die tonight, where would you go? Would you go to heaven or would you go to hell?" And at the time, you know, I wasn't quite sure. And then he was describing what hell would be like. Likening it to being in the middle of the campfire, but never burning out. At the time, I was kind of scared. I wasn't sure. I was afraid that I might go to hell. And so he gave us the opportunity where we could receive Jesus Christ, and me and a bunch of other boys in our cabin, we received Jesus that night. And some verses in Romans could tell us about the new life that we have in Jesus. It's Romans chapter 8, verses 1 through 4, it says, "Therefore, there is no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus, because through Christ Jesus, the law of the Spirit of life set me free from the law of sin and death. For what the law was powerless to do, in that it was weakened by the sinful nature, God did it by sending his Son in the likeness of sinful man to be a sin offering. And so he condemned sin and sinful man in order that the righteous requirements of the law might be fully met in us, who do not live according to the sinful nature, but according to the Spirit." And I mean, my whole life is since that time is since that first week of camp, I didn't have any, you know, roundabout or, you know, 180 degree turn changes. But my life has been gradually a change in improving my attitudes and ultimately the desires for all of us who want to, who are Christians, should be. They're told about in Ephesians chapter 4, verses 22 through 24. It says, "You are taught with regard to your former way of life to put off your old self, which is being corrupted by its deceitful desires, to be made new in the attitude of your mind, and to put on the new self, created to be like God in true righteousness and holiness." In the words of this next song, "I want to be like Jesus," really, they express my desire and hopefully the desire of every Christian that we will be like Jesus someday.
Is nearer now than when we first believe. The night is nearly over, the day is almost here, so let us put aside the depths of darkness and put on the armor of light.
Thank you.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.